So guys, what I'm going to show you in this video is this cell phone that I've designed and built from scratch. And basically I've been dreaming of doing this for a long time. It all started when I got my first cell phone. I think it was 1999 or 2000, I guess. It was a Bosch 608 model. And back in those days, GSM was just starting to become popular, and every time after that, each time I got a new phone, I thought, well, wouldn't it be great to just be able to build something similar to this, you know, the real cell phone. And I've been using GSM in a lot of projects that were involving sending data or commands using the short messaging system, and even voice communication. But I still wanted to build the cell phone itself, you know, and I finished this prototype a while ago, and I just didn't have the time to make a video about this until now. So this is the last iteration out of many other different attempts, designs. Some designs use smaller displays, other components, and this is, well, I still have some things I would like to change, you know, use a different approach on a future version. But other than that, it's pretty much a finished design. I could probably add an onboard microphone and a speaker, because at this point the telephone is only using a headset for voice communication, and I would probably change this antenna connector here. So with all that being said, now I'm going to show you how it works. First things first, its name. I called this the Weaver MPX, and you can see here on the back side the battery is hiding pretty much everything else. So I'm going to remove the battery, and the phone is using a micro SD card for the data and a micro SIM card. So I'm going to look for a SIM card and remove the battery, and then I'm going to show you the back side of the board. On the front side, obviously, it's this big display here, a few connectors, a few LEDs, and two push buttons. So I removed the battery, and as you can see, most of the components are on the back side of the PCB. Here's the heart of the whole cell phone, the XMega 128A3U. It's the XMega series of the 8mm AVR. It's a decent microcontroller. Here's the GSM module, two card slots, one for the SIM card, one for the micro SD card. Here's the touch panels controller for the LCD touch panel. And on this side of the board, there's a power supply for the whole circuit. The board uses three different voltages, 2.8, 3 and 3.3 volts. I use a lithium ion standard battery to power up everything. Here's the charging circuit for the battery through this micro USB connector. I charge the battery. There's a micro switch here to turn it on and off, and a few components for the matching circuit for the antenna connector on this side. And that's pretty much everything on the component side. Now I'll place the battery back. I'm using this double adhesive tape to hold it into position. So I'm going to put the battery back. First, I'm going to insert the SIM card into this slot. The micro SD card is already present here. And now I'm going to place the battery back over the components. Something like that. And now I'm going to connect the antenna. There are three status LEDs on board. The blue one is blinking, is slowly blinking when there's GSM connection available, so the SIM card is present. Obviously the cell phone is turned on, and the SIM card has successfully authenticated on the GSM network. If there's a problem, if the SIM card is not present or the signal is not strong enough, you're just out of service, the blue LED will blink faster. And then these two LEDs here, the green one is showing that the power is on, so basically it's just a power indicator, and the red LED here will be on when I connect the USB battery charger, and will go off as soon as the battery is completely recharged. For demonstration purposes only, I'm gonna use another antenna because this room where I'm filming right now is very shielded. Signal strength is very low. On the display, as you can see, on the top left corner there's a battery indicator, top right corner the signal strength indicator, and here's the keyboard. Obviously I'm using the touch screen of the display as input method because there are no push buttons or physical keys. The green button, it's a standard take the call or dial a new number. The red button, also standard clear any dialed number or reject any incoming calls. And here in the middle there's a phone book application. So the way this works is on the SD card there's a folder, and you can save all these contacts into this folder. For each contact you can save its name, its telephone number, and you can make a photo and place it into this folder. So basically if you get an incoming call originated from a number which is saved in your phone book, you will see its name, the name of the contact, and you will see the photo if there is a photo available in the folder. If I don't press anything for like a couple of seconds, the display illumination will go off to save the energy, and it will come back on as soon as I'm touching the display again. And there's also a screen lock that can be activated by pressing the two hardware keys at the same time. And if I do this again, it will deactivate the screen lock. Screen lock is good if you put it in your pocket and you want to prevent it from dialing a number or answering someone's call, even if it didn't press anything. I'm gonna go ahead and dial a number now. I'm gonna just dial it manually. And press dial. Now I'm gonna take a number from the phone book. And now I'm gonna show you an incoming call. So I'm gonna call this number from another phone and see what happens. Testing. Now obviously I can change the software and do another menu or implement other functions, but I don't think I want that. I like it the way it is. I just want to keep it simple, just a simple cell phone. Oh, and I forgot to show you, I used the photo diode here between these two connectors, and I can use this to adjust the brightness of the display in real time. I didn't implement that in software either. I guess It's not very difficult, it's just pulse width, a simple pulse width modulation. There's a few lines of code. So anyway, this was the Weaver MPX cell phone. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this as much as I do. I'm very pleased how it came out. It's a very rewarding feeling holding this, carrying it with me. When it rings and you take the call, it generates a lot of attention. You know, somebody asks you, hey man, what's that and where did you get that from? And you explain them it's your own design and manufacturer cell phone. It raises a few eyebrows, and let's just say it's a feeling no money can buy. Anyway, thanks again. Please share this video, subscribe to the channel, and drop some likes. If this video does well enough, I might consider doing another video, get into more technical details, show you some schematics, how I did the PCB, perhaps speak about doing the software for these things. Be safe, and I'll catch you on the next video.